What's up, guys? It is Bernardo from the BTNHD, and today is all about creating a smart deploy USB media within Windows Server 2019. I have to look up and down because I'm trying to remember what's going on. So let's get into it. All right, so today is all about creating a smart deploy USB media, and the first thing that we need to do is open up your smart deploy console. And once you're here, you want to click on Reimage Devices, and within Reimage Devices, you're going to click on Create Media. It's going to start loading up. You're going to click on next here. And we already took care of one task here, which was the deployment package. Today, we're going to focus on boot media and also offline deployment media. So for our first option, we're going to pick boot media. Click next. You're going to pick all your platform packs. Click next. From here, you're going to click on browse and select your answer file. So I'm going to select the one that we created together. Then I'm going to click on next. Because I'm doing everything within a virtual environment, I'm not going to do the USB part. So I'm going to pick DVD. And within DVD, click on next. From here, I need to save my ISO image file. So I'm going to click on browse. And then it's automatically going to drop it inside the Smart Deploy Media folder. So I'm going to leave the file name as is. Click on save. Click next here. Click finish. It's going to start creating the media and you're done. So click OK. If you go inside the Smart Deploy Media folder, you're going to see your ISO. Now, this is the boot media part, right? Not offline. Big difference between the boot media and offline, because look at the size of the boot media. Now we're going to do the offline deployment media. So do the whole process again. Go inside Activities, go inside Reimage Devices, go inside Create Media, click on Next, and you're going to get this. And then for this part, we are going to pick offline deployment media. And when you click on next, it's going to want you to pick your image file. When you click on browse, it's going to automatically take you inside the Smart Deploy image folder. And you're going to pick your WIN file. Select it. Click OK. Click next. Pick your platform packs. Click next here. And then you need to pick your answer file. So I'm going to click on browse. Select my answer file. Click on open. Click on next. If you have any application packs, just move them to your right and then click next. Again, I'm not going to do USB because I'm within a virtual machine, so I'm going to pick DVD. And within DVD, I forgot to show you, within the drop-down menu, you are able to pick 64-bit or 32-bit, but two types of the DVD. You got DL, which is double layer, and then you have SL, which is single layer. Once you pick what you want, click on next. From here, we need to save our image file. So I'm going to click on browse. It's going to drop it inside the Smart Deploy Media folder. And I'm going to change the name to underscore offline. You can name it whatever you want. Click on save. Click on next. Finish. And it's going to start processing and creating the media for you. And then once it's done, boom. That's it. You're going to click OK on that. And if you go back inside the Smart Deploy Media folder, you're going to see two ISO files. The first ISO file, which is Smart Deploy, was the one that we created with boot media. And the second one is the one that we did offline deployment media. And you see the size is huge. It's about 7 gigs in size. So that's a pretty huge one. So that's the one that I'm definitely going to use. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. Make sure to hit that like button. Also, do not forget about punching elbow and smashing that subscribe button to get the latest and greatest from this guy. And I'll catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.